was cool. Thank you for coming this evening. I really appreciate you taking the time out. I was just messing with you. I'll start off tonight. This is our first piece we're going to play. It's called Barbarossa. Barbarossa has to do with Operation Barbarossa from World War II. So that's the German invasion, or the attempted invasion of Russia, which didn't go so well for the Germans. So it's kind of a pivotal point of World War II. This piece is very unique because it's, number one, really hard. And number two, it's because I gave it to him on Monday. And I was like, maybe we shouldn't play this. They're like, oh yeah, we should play it. And man, they play it. My gosh, they worked hard to get it to this day. So I'm really excited. This is Barbarossa.
Thank you.
So full disclosure, I want you to know I'm like, I love your kids. I love them so much. This is my favorite part of the day. This is like our varsity middle school day. And I love each and every one of them. We're a really small group, but in a way it's really cool. And it does make it harder because we have sometimes one on a part, except for saxophone, that we have a bazillion. But everything else is pretty much one on a part, and they do a great job too, saxophone. We're gonna feature them later too. So I have a lot of awards, and I'll try to get through them quickly, but at the same time, and I already told them this, and they rolled their eyes at me, but I wanna have them come up here in the front. Feel free to take as many pictures you like. If you wanna come around, move around, stuff like that, when they come up, feel free to, because I think that's great. Okay, so this is our first awards for the night. This is for the ATSSB, which is the Association of Texas Small School Bands, all region band. So this is something we normally, they work up a piece or two pieces and a bunch of scales, and they have to go audition. Usually we go to Pampa, and then they're ranked and placed in one of two bands, and then we go to WT. So, you know, the higher you're ranked, you're in the top band and bottom band, and then you're among the best musicians in the region, which is really cool. This year, unfortunately, they didn't have the concert, but they did get their passions and programs and all that, and so I want to recognize them with their certificates. So if y'all will come up and just kind of line across the stage. So these are all region members from this year, and then I have a couple of other ones that are multiple years and then some other stuff. So first is Ray Knight. So when you have 9 in a band of 27, you're like, maybe we should add some difference. So they switched to tenor and Barry, and so did Eli back there too. Okay, next is Bryson Archer on trumpet. And Shay Curtin on trumpet. And then Elliot Hempel as well, he couldn't be with us tonight. Dallas Griffin on trombone. It's just Dallas is in 7th grade, and we wanted to have him play with our varsity band this year because he was so impressive last year, especially Mr. Diamond had him doing online teaching, and he said he was just incredible, especially even, I mean, trying to do band on a computer is pretty difficult, and Dallas was like, okay, sure, we're good. And he was 5th chair in the region this year, so he was the best of the best at 7th and 8th. It was awesome. Next is Colton Reynolds on tuba. Javier Medina on tuba. And Ryan Aguilar on percussion. All right. Okay, now so this is our all region band members. And then these next three people, these are people that got first chair in the whole region. So they beat out everybody 7th and 8th. We went all the way to the top of the panhandle, all the way south towards Lubbock, east and west, all the way. So that's a lot of kids. I think there was something like 1,500 to 2,000 kids this year's audition. So these three are the best of the best in the region, okay? So first is Denise Sacedo on alto saxophone. Next is Austin Woodard on French horn. And Jason Misk on tuba. Next, these are our three people that have made the all-region band both years. They made it not only as a 7th grader, but also as an 8th grader. And as a 7th grader, it's really difficult because you're going up as a outgoing 6th grader, going into 7th grade, and you have people that have played for 2 years ahead of you. And so these three people made it both years. They made it last year in the sheet. So first is Mason Bogan on saxophone. Next is Eli Cochran on saxophone. Finally, Quinn Brassfield on percussion. So, percentage-wise, Bushland had the highest amount, and yeah, we're a small band, but we have the highest amount of not only first chairs, we have the most first chairs in the region, and also the highest percentage of students. So give them a hand. Sun Chaser. It's by actually a French horn player in Lubbock. Her name is Carol Britton Chaser. She went to Tech, and now she's writing these fabulous compositions. The high school played one at the concert last week. So Sun Chaser, it's the kind of idea behind it is you're chasing the sun. You're trying to go faster than the speed of light. And it's really kind of an inspiring thing to attain the unattainable. Okay? Sun Chaser was our third piece this year. We played for UIL concert in Cyrene. You saw probably our trophy on the outside there. This is our 14th consecutive Division I that this band has made. So way back since the band started going to UIL, which is fantastic. And man, did they fight for it this year. It was everything going against them, not only their size, but where we could rehearse, when we could rehearse. And on top of everything else, we went from a size 1C middle school to a 2C middle school this year. So that's like going from like a 3 to a 4A or something like that. And so with that, you have to read more difficult pieces. And when we sight read, we have to sight read, which sight reading is when they give you a piece of music for the first time, and I have 5 minutes to teach it, and then they play on stage. And their sight reading was actually the same level as the high school varsity band this year. So 2C reads at the same level as a 3A high school. So extremely difficult, and they handled it with no problem. And this piece means a lot to me, and it means a lot to them, and I'm very proud of our performance at UIL Concert and Sight Reading. So here is Sun Chaser.
Thank you.
So we give awards for each section in eighth grade, and they have these plaques that hang up in the band hall above our offices in the middle school. And for each individual instrument, we have outstanding brass player, outstanding woodwind player, outstanding percussionist, and most improved. So I'm going to give a couple of those right now because I realize I left some of the other certificates on my desk. Mr. Smith's going to give them. So we'll start tonight. This is this year's outstanding woodwind player. So this is somebody that is coming from either the clarinet, saxophone, or flute section. And this is somebody who definitely, if I'm not awake by 10 a.m., I am awake after I see him every day. And it's a good thing, though, man, because he's so high energy every day, and he definitely puts a smile on my face every day. And in his own words, he carried the saxophones on his back. So this goes to Mason Bogan. For a judge, and they're ranked out of four. And so this award, because we didn't have a spring concert last year, this is for anybody that did a solo last year or also this year. It kind of distinguishes on the certificate. So there's going to be some people that are going to be like, I got an award or I do a solo this year. It's because they did one last year. You can tell them that. Okay, so same procedure as before, having solos and papers. First is Ray Knight. Outstanding award right now. So this is for our outstanding brass player. So this is from either the French horns, trumpets, baritones, trombones, or tubas. And this is somebody from the tuba section, and someone that not only in this ensemble is just an absolute leader, but literally everything he does, and I do mean he does everything, because every time there's an announcement, an email, a letter, my box, anything, it has this guy's name on it. And he is impressive. The guy's going to be president one day. So this goes to Jace Fisk. serious stuff. So we're gonna have some fun now. I want to feature tonight. I want to introduce you first of all to two of our staff. Brad Smith is playing clarinet with us, and also even more recent to our staff is Brandon Bora on guitar. Beyond lucky to have them in our district. They're both professional musicians. They both play in the Emerald Symphony. Mr. Warwick is a professor at Emerald College, and they play gigs on the weekends. You might see them at restaurants, stuff like that, so they're legit. And they love working with your kids, and as much as I do, I know. Well, maybe rock not quite as much, because I love your kids a lot. But they really, really like, for sure, working with this band especially, and I'm very lucky to have them. So this next piece we're gonna play is popularized by being on the radio. This is Blinding Lights by The Weeknd. This is our most improved award, and this is, again, talking about saxophones, which we're fixing to go there again, but there is an army of saxophones in this band, and every single one of them are amazing players. I mean, seriously, top notch. The saxophones at the All Region pamphlet was like Bushland, 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 Bushland. It was incredible. Like, they were just top notch. And so this is somebody that just blew me out of the water when I heard her audition, and she has improved just unbelievably well the past year, and I can't wait to see what she does in high school. So this is Denise Sosa. Okay, got two more. So this is one that the person that this is dedicated to was here during a sixth grade concert, then he had a rehearsal he needed to go to. But I just want to talk a little bit about the award itself. This is a new award we're getting this year. The band that's in front of you, the sixth grade band, all the junior high bands, and for that matter, this program, really two people just put in the work every day for years to make it as good as it is today. Those people wanted great dining, of course. other is Joe Woolsey. And Joe Woolsey, he's so with us. I keep talking about this like it's a memorial. He was here earlier. But I wish I had more words in my vocabulary to say what he means to me, to Mr. Diamond, and this program. He has put in just tremendous amount of work, and more importantly, he cared about the kids, and he still cares about the kids more than anything. That's what this whole thing is about, is making music with your kids. And so this is the Joe Woolsey Award for Band, and it's going to have a plaque here, and you'll be kind of able to see, well, it's pretty small, but you'll be able to see who got it, but I'm not going to tell the person. But this is going to hang in the band hall outside of what was his office. And every year we'll award it to somebody. And this person, the person that's going to get it every year is somebody who I believe is just completely dedicated to this program every single day and works hard no matter what and is just very passionate about everything they do, not only in music. So let me switch over to the actual person now. So the person that this is going to this year, the first day that I met him, that came to band hall, I knew he was going to be a leader. And he is definitely going to be a leader in our high school program. He's an asset to our program. It's always, what can I do to help? What piece of music can I help you with if we're missing a part or something like that? There's no questions asked. It's always just first. And he is mature and just everything beyond his years. And incidentally enough, we gave a similar award to his sister at the last concert. So this award this year goes to Russell Castro. To somebody who, again, very similar to that award, is just dedicated to our program, dedicated to do whatever it takes for excellence, and that's what we expect, and that's what we achieve, and what we achieve this year. And this person, again, just an outstanding young man who is incredible at an instrument, and somebody who had a personal struggle this year because he got braces. And if you don't know on a brass instrument, braces is like having a cheese grater in the front of your mouth, and it just rips everything up. Sorry about that visual, but it hurts and it's hard, and man, he was like, oh, okay, sure, whatever, and did it anyway. No complaints at all. So I was always like, hey, man, do you need help? No, I'm good. And he just did it. Played whatever I needed to, just pushed ahead, even though sometimes I could see that his face was about to explode. But man, you want to talk about a leader, and again, someone who's going to be a complete asset to our high school band, and somebody that's going to be drum major or captain or something someday in our Falcon band. So that's Bryson Archer. It's a wonderful program too, but they get absorbed into this bigger entity. And I love this mission, and I know they do too. It's very personal. And so I thank you very much for all the time you've given and allowing them to be in my care and under my direction for the past couple of years. And I really, really do appreciate you, and I love your kids very much. So this last piece, I keep complaining about them, but this is going to feature the saxophone section. And they're going to come up here and come. Yeah, that's like half a band, right? Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, it's fine. So this piece, I think, is really cool. And the title, we're trying to come up with something that sounded a little bit better. The title's called Saxes Will Rock. I think it kind of sounds like Layla a little bit. But we're going to feature them, and we're going to feature Mr. Borup on our drum set. And that'll be it. So you can go home and eat there.